Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I wanted to do an updo but use a little bit more intricate style braids. So let me know what you think about this style down below in the comment section. Make sure to like and subscribe if you're new to my channel. If you're already subscribed, thank you so much. Be sure to click that bell so you never miss any future videos. And let's get started. Since this hairstyle has two braids on one side, I'm going to part my hair on the right side. So there's more hair on the left side that I can work with to create the braids. Now I'm going to pin the crown section so I don't pull this hair into the braids. So I'm dividing off a section on the right side of the crown, and I'm going to gently twist the hair together and then pin it at the center of the back of my head using some bobby pins. Then I'm going to divide off a section on the left side of the crown. I'm going to gently twist this hair together and then lay it at the back of my head over the right section and pin it in place with a couple more bobby pins. Once that's pinned, I'm going to gently pull out small sections of hair to create some texture and volume in this crown section. Now I'm going to create the four strand braid. So I'm going to divide off a small section of hair on the left side of the part next to the crown section. I'm going to divide the section into four pieces, and to create the four strand braid, I'm going to cross the fourth strand at the back under the third strand. Then I'm going to cross it over the second strand and then under the first strand. Then I'm going to cross the second strand under the third strand. So now I'm repeating those steps. I'm going to cross the fourth strand under the third strand, over the second strand, and then under the first strand. And now I'm going to pick up a new section of hair from the front side of the braid and add it into that first strand that was crossed over the fourth strand. Then I'm going to cross the second strand under the third strand again. As you can see, there is a pattern when creating a four strand braid, and you can create it either by focusing on the first strand or the fourth strand, but it always follows the same pattern, either under, over, under, over, or over, under, over, under, depending on which side of the braid you start with. I am going to pick up a new section of hair from the front side of the braid each time and incorporate it into the braid. And each strand, except the third strand, will gradually get hair incorporated into it. The third strand won't ever have additional hair brought into it, so it will stay small and thin, but this will add some dimension to the size of the braid. And I did this on purpose, not adding in any additional hair to that piece. If you want all of the strands to be the same size, you can add in additional hair into this third section from directly underneath the braid. I only brought in hair to the front side of the braid and didn't incorporate any hair into the back side of the braid so that I could lay it either lower or higher on my head once it was all done. But once the braid reaches above my left ear, before it starts to curve around the back of my head, I'm going to stop incorporating new sections of hair into the braid and just repeat the same steps, continuing the braid down to the ends. And then I'm going to slide a couple bobby pins over the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Using bobby pins on the bottom instead of a hair elastic will make pulling out the braid to make it wider easier to do. So now with the remaining hair in front of the four strand braid, I'm going to create a three strand lace style braid. So I'm dividing off a small section near the part and splitting it into three smaller pieces. I'm crossing the side strands over the middle, and I'm going to incorporate new sections into the front side of the braid only. Since this section of hair is so small, I'm going to be incorporating new sections on every other stitch of the braid, and this will help keep the lace style along the full length of the braid, or at least a little bit longer than if you brought in a section on each stitch. And then once the braid reaches the bottom, again, I'm just going to slide a couple bobby pins over the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Next, I'm going to divide off the front section of hair on the right side of my head that was left out of the crown section and pin this at the back of my head. I'm going to divide off the hair at the top first. Then I'm going to add in a new section below that, crossing it over the first section. Then I'm going to pick up another section below the others and cross this over the section as well. And I'm going to bring this section around the back of my head, laying it over the crown section, and then just pin it in place with a bobby pin. Now I'm going to pin up the two braids from the left side. So I'm going to start with the four strand braid, and I'm going to first gently pull on the edges of the braid so that it becomes wider and looks more full. So starting at the bottom of the braid, I'm going to carefully slide the sides out of the bobby pin at the bottom and work my way up to the top of the braid. And once the braid is as wide as I like, I'm going to bring it around the back of my head and pin it at the bottom of the crown section. Now I'm going to take the smaller braid and bring this around to the back of my head as well and pin it in place. My braid was a little bit shorter and didn't reach all the way around, so I slid the end underneath the top four-strand braid and then pinned it there using a bobby pin. Next, I'm going to do the low bun portion of the hairstyle. So I'm going to combine the remaining hair together near the nape of my neck. And then using a hairband, I'm going to wrap this once over the hair. Then I'm going to twist the band over my right hand and split the ponytail into two sections. I'm going to take the top section and spread the hair up so there's kind of a center hole in the middle of the ponytail. I'm going to take my hairband and pull it over the split hair to create the bun. And I wrapped my hairband twice over the bun just to make sure it would hold nice and tight. And now I'm going to go back over the bun and pull the hair in opposite directions to both tighten the bun against my head as well as reshape the bun so it's more even all the way around. And then I just have to tuck the ends in somehow. So I'm going to divide this hair into two sections, and I'm going to tuck them back into the hair, creating two more looped sections of the bun. So with one section, I'm going to loop this back towards the hairband on the left side of the bun, and just tuck the hair around the hairband to hold it in place. Then I'm going to take the other section of ends and loop this back towards the hairband underneath the bun, tucking the hair around the hairband to hold it in place. And once all of the hair is wrapped up, I'm going to go back over the bun and make sure that it looks the way that I like. So I'm going to pin down any sections that are sticking out. I want the bun to be flush with my head and not kind of poking out from my head. And then, of course, I'm going to spray the style with a medium hold hairspray to help smooth down any loose hairs and flyaway pieces. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Make sure to comment down below what you think about this style. I think four strand braids can be a little bit tricky, so let me know if you think the style was a little bit too difficult. If you're new to my channel, make sure to like and subscribe. Click that bell, then you'll never miss any future videos. And I will see you next time.